sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvinavadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai om shanti 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 samast janakalyane niratam karunamayam namami chinmayam devam sadgurum brahma vidvaram om sri vidvana sadgurave namaha. We are trying to discuss Ganapati Atharvashirsha Upanishad. Atharvashirsha Upanishad is the correct name. And we should not forget that it being Upanishad, it is full of tatva chintan. So it is not just a stuti stotra of a deity. There is stuti of Ganapati into it. But we cannot forget that it being Upanishad, which is nothing else but the Vedanta, which is nothing else but the tatva chintana, the mantras are there for manana. We were trying to see Ganapati represents what? Bhagavan Ganesh means precisely what? We have seen his shape, his size, his rupa. We are well known. We are well versed with it. From childhood, we have been seeing Ganesha. But what is the Ganesha that is by Abhida expected here and by Lakshana expected here? So the attempt is not to forget that we are studying an Atharvashirsha Upanishad. We saw that a prayer was done last time where we stopped. We saw that a prayer was done to him that protect me. Avatvam mam, avavaktaram, avashrotaram, avadataram, avadhataram, avanuchanam, avashisham, avapashchatat, avapurostat, avachordhvatat, avadharatat, sarvatomam, pahi pahi samantat. A prayer was made for the protection of me. Me means who? Not XYZ. Me means the Jeeva. Before praying to the God, I must know who I am. Once I know that I am a Jeeva, which is nothing else but an entity which is trapped in samsarana, samsara. Janma Mrityu Chakra has been a curse that has been bestowed upon me by the very fact that I am a Jeeva. If I am a Jeeva, then I don't want to be a Jeeva forever. Then what I want to be? I want to be Shiva. So the process of making Jeeva and reaching to Shiva is sadhana. And how this sadhana culminates? It culminates by segregating the upadhi of the Jeeva and then removing the upadhi from the kutastha or the atma tattvam and making that atma tattvam one with the Brahman. That is Jeeva Shiva Milana. There is no other purpose of our existence on this earth. The question is whether Jeeva Shiva Milan is so easy. I pray and I will get it. The way it is imperative that I must first know that I am a Jeeva and a Jeeva is a Baddha or it has Bandhana. it is equally important to know that his bandhanas are coming from where. The moola bandhanam is avidya. What is avidya? We are going to see in the subsequent mantras. But the manifestation of that moola bandhanam, avidya, are the adversities of sukham dukham that we are seeing all around. Because I am subjected to the illusory status as me, that is this body, deha tadatmya, the jeeva, which is deluded and calling itself as deha, is suffering from dukkham, anukula pratikula vedana. That is the story about, this is our biography. One line biography of a jeeva is that which is subjected to the vagaries of dukkham and sukham. The reason is because he has ahankar with it. The reason why he has ahankar is because of avidya. Now once we know who I am, where I am trapped, and how can I vimuchyate, release myself from these conditions, that is the time I need protection. Why protection? Because I have got issues coming from three sources. Either they will come from the vishayas, they are called adhibouthika, or they will come from the divine source, adhidaivika, or they can come from me, myself, adhyatmika. Other than that, there is no source of any kind of dukkha bandhana. So when these obstacles are likely to come, what will happen? I will be frightened in the whole scene. Once I am frightened, my ability to withstand the obstacle that has come will go down so much that I cannot think of my sadhana of making myself the Shiva. The Jeev has to become Shiva. That is the sadhana. And that is why the biggest deity which can actually tackle the obstacle, I need its help. So I call Vignaharta Ganesha and I pray to him, O Lord, avatvam maam, protect me, avavaktaram, avashrotaram, jo bol raha hai, usko bhi protect karo, uska bhi rakshan karo, jo sun raha hai, uska bhi karo, kyunki shravan is my only way to get some jnanam. So if everybody around me is protected, because my own protection will not be possible, the protection will be coming, this rakshanam will be coming, when everybody is rakshitaha, then my protection, my suraksha, my rakshanam will be coming. So please protect me from adhidaivika, adhibhautika and adhyatmika tap, or the dukkham and sukham, which can come from any corner. It could be because of past, avapashchatat. It could be because of my worry about the future, avaporostat. It could be about I thinking about lav paralaukika sukha, avachordhvatat. It could be because I'm worried that I may go to patal, avachordhvatat. Sarvatomam pahi pahi samantat. There is not a source or a corner left from where the obstacles can come. Why? Because so much of deeds I have done in the past. My vittam, my jama kharcha, my balance sheet is not very healthy. Yallabhase nija karmo pate vittam tenam vinodaya chittam. Nija karmo pate, it has come because of my karma. God, what can I do? So many issues are coming to me. I want to pray to you forever, but there is a problem. The child is creating a problem. The wife is creating the problem. The husband is creating the problem. The family is creating the problem. The boss is creating the problem. If not anything, then adhibhautika, the virus, is creating the problem. There are issues galloring everywhere. Now, if I alone want to tackle the issues, by now I have realized that I cannot even tackle one issue properly. Why? Because alpa buddhi, santa shakti. So I need a protection from the one and one only who can protect. Why? Because he is Vignaharta. So Vignaharta Ganesha, please protect me from all the sides. And then comes the fourth mantra, which says, tvam vangmayam. Tvam vangmaya. What is vangmaya? Vang is the shabd that has come from speech. Vak. Vak is speech. What is the speech and the power of the speech? The power of the speech is so great that the Indian philosophy has taken Shabda as nothing else but Brahman. It's called Shabda Brahma. The sound of the Shabda is called Nada Brahma. So this sound itself, Shabda is also a part of a sound. Shabda is creation of a sound in a particular manner. So the sound, the Nada itself is a signage of a Brahman. The question here is, how the sound is going to help me and why should I be so grateful for the sound? Because the entire infinitude or multitude of things that are around me are nothing else but naam rupatmak. Everything around me has a name and a shape or a form, naam rupatmak. And my life is nothing else but interaction of me with the things that are around me, which are naam rupatmak. Now my interaction with whatever is happening or things around me is possible only and only through the communication that I make. Now I'm talking to you and you are able to comprehend what I'm talking, if at all you are comprehending. The reason is because the word that is coming from the mouth has been articulated by this articulatory apparatus called mouth, depending upon whether the varna is danta, talavya, aushtha, etc. But that has come again from the laryngeal box here, where the word got a shape and it was finally molded by my articulation, and then it came out as ka, pa, ma, whatever. Then it got combined together to make some meaningful word, and then the word or the sound, when it was released from my mouth, it was already impregnated with the meaning. So what happened here? Shabda and the artha both got combined. So shabda artha sahita iti sahityam. That is why the word is sahitya. Sahiti, shabda and artha, because only shabda coming to you will not make any sense. Artha cannot reach you unless it rides on the top of the word. Now this, because everyday affair, we do not realize the importance of word. Ask a dumb person what is the importance of speech and he will tell you, oh, what I have lost, you don't know. Why? Because now he has to do so much of exercise to communicate what he wants to say. And this communication which you are saying is basically for shravanam. When somebody speaks, he doesn't speak just for that, because somebody is going to hear it. And then what is the importance of this hearing? This hearing alone is the only method by which the modalities of my sadhana can come to me, either by reading Diksha Guru or my Shiksha Guru, one who is going to teach me. His words will come on my Karna Patala, and then the artha that is associated with that shabda will make changes in my mind. And when they make change in my mind, my thought pattern will change. My thought process will change. This is the power of the word. Kabir Maharaj said, sabad sabad har koi kahe, sabad ke haath na paav. Ek sabad aushudh kare, ek sabad kare ghao. Moment somebody calls you near and says, you stupid. Actually, he has not touched you. He has not done anything to you. The word alone carries the meaning and you are full of anger inside. That is the power of the word. So this power in the word is nothing else but shakti. So the artha shakti is nothing else but the reflection of that shakti. It is the same shakti which enlivens the word. And that is why amongst the many pramanas we have in Advaita Vedanta and Purva Mimamsa, shad pramanas are there. One of the important and the most important pramana is shabda. Today we read about Gurudeva and what he has said, what Vivekananda had said. We hear him or we read him and his words make impact on him. That is because shabda is one pramana which can transform a person. So that is the reason Navavidha Bhakti starts with Shravanam. And what is the Shravanam without word? So first thing is to have the word. To have the word, you should have meaning into it. To combine the meaning, Shabd and Artha together, what we have to do? First, we have to have some idea about what the meaning of that particular word is. So the ideation kalpana is the first thing. So ideation happening at the paravani, utsphurtata, where the ideation happens. As it moves up, it forms concrete shape based on the previous smriti that we have, the knowledge that we have with the smriti jnana, and the kind of knowledge we have with the vidya that we have acquired. The ideation which was there in paravani, in the paschanti vani, you are able to see it in some form. Now it starts getting the form. By the time it reaches madhyama, it has already come to the what is called as crystallization of its, the marriage between the word and the meaning is already done there. All it needs is finer articulation of the sound so that the other person can understand it. One who is speaking has already understood it by the time it reaches madhyama. Zaba hamare paas bhi hai, kaash poochho mudda kya hai, Sufi says. Mudda yahan pe hai. Zuban khuli nahi hai. Why? I have not given it the vent as yet, as he says. So these four vanis which are there, this vani creates what is called as vangmaya. Everything in this world is nothing else but vangmaya. Just stop talking and hearing what is left in the world. Eyes will see. Ears will not hear. Why? There is no sound. If there is no sound, existence is impossible. And that is why whatever is spoken and heard and meaningfully heard, because the shakti has been given into it, vacho vibhanti nikhila yad anugrahena. Nikhila, like lightning, the meaning gets impregnated into the word. And who does this? Nothing else but it is because of Lord Ganesha's kripa. That is why, hey Lord Ganesha, you are vangmaya. Tvam vangmaya. Tvam chinmaya. Immediately after the vangmaya, the word chinmaya has come. Chidmaya. Iti chinmayam. Chidmaya becomes chinmaya. Chidmaya means what? Chidmaya is nothing but embodiment of consciousness. If you say chid alone, only word chit, that means you are talking of consciousness. Unidentified, undiluted, nitya shuddha brahma. Chit. Because it is the part of Satchitananda brahma. Moment we say chidmaya, chinmaya means you are talking of embodied consciousness. Embodied consciousness means now the consciousness hasn't remained alone, but has got itself embodied. Embodied means upadhi. Purushottama has become kshetra jnya, and that is why kshetra is created. Lord says, I am kshetra jnya. Vidhimam kshetra jnya. Ye sab jo hai, whatever is there is kshetra. Till what time? Till the kshetra is existing, kshetradni will exist. And when both are not existing, purushottam will exist. So chinmaya means everything that is embodied consciousness or upadhi matra is you. What do you mean by that? What it means is, everything is ganeshamaya. But I have already spoken to somebody who is a wicked person. Then how he can be Ganesha? He is also Ganesha. But I saw an animal today. He is also Ganesha. How is it possible that the animal is Ganesha? The chit part of that animal or the wicked person, the kutastha of that person, the chetana of that person is Ganesha. The use of chetana as a chidabhasa done by that particular upadhi is as per his karma. That is not Ganesha. Tremendous amount of moha, greed I have. This is not Ganesha. But I am able to exercise my greed because of whom? It is like this. A father gave a lot of money to his child. He was a very pious person. He gave money to his child. The child decided to spend it on bad things. the father is not to be blamed. Why? He gave the vitta, the money. The money was misused. So Bhagavan gave the consciousness to us. That is why I'm speaking, you are listening. But what are we using this particular ability of Bhagavan's consciousness? The same words are used for abusing somebody. And the ears are used for hearing abhadram. That is the reason Shanti Mantra started as Bhadram Karanebhi Sunyam. So abhadra hi sunne ki aadat hai. So jo abhadra sun raha hai, usko bhi Bhagavan hi madad kar raha hai. Choro ke sang chori karta badmasho mein bhedo tu. Chori karke jo pakad jave, pakadne wala tu ka tu. Kabir Maharaj says, chor bhi tu hai. Badmash bhi tu hai. Pakadne wala bhi tu hai, bhediya bhi tu hai. What does it mean? It means the consciousness that enlivens, the principle of consciousness is enlivening everything. So there is nothing wrong with that. That is why Kabir Maharaj says, if at all the vacha is given to you, its purpose is very simple. The vacha is meant for remembering the consciousness, remembering the Rama, remembering the Narayana, remembering the Vithala. Kehta Kabir Raman Jamukh Tamukh Dhulabhari. Bhajore Bhaya Ram Govinda Hari. Sadhana Japatapa Lagena Kucha. Kharchatana Gathari. Bhajore Bhaya Ram Govinda Hari. The word, that is why Tvam Chinmayam. Tvam Anandamaya Tvam Brahmamaya. In this mantra, Ananda word has come at two times. Tvam Anandamaya Tvam Brahmamaya. And then said, Tvam Sachidananda. Ek Anand hai, ek Sachidanand hai. Ye kya hai? What is the difference? Tvam Anand, Maya word came, that means embodiment of bliss. Moment we say embodiment, we are talking of Kshetra and Kshetradnya. That means Apara Brahma, Sopadhika Brahma, not Nirupadhika Brahma, not Parabrahma. So when we say Tvam Anandamaya, that means the Anandam which we get in our Kshetra is also you. Why? Because you also enliven there. You enliven my happiness. Whenever I am happy, that happiness is coming from where? It is coming from Ichha Purti. A momentary, transitory Chitta Shubdhata Shanti happening subsequent to the Upabhoga of the Vishaya gives Anandam, which is nothing because it is only because of the reflection of Parabrahman or Atma Tattvam in Chitta, and we call it happiness, and we blame it or we give the reasoning as that what I ate jalebi was very good, so I felt happy. Jalebi does not make me happy. It is the Kshanika Chitta Vritti Vishranti. Chitta Vritti stops for a microsecond and you feel aha. That aha is not because of jalebi, it is because of reflection of Kutastha into Chidabhasa. So that Anandam is nothing else but Ganapati. Tvam Brahma Mayaha. Again the word Mayaha has come. Which is this Brahman? This is Apara Brahman. This is Sopadika Brahman. That means all the gods, whatever you see as manifested world, the manifested world innervated by the consciousness is the Apara Brahma that you are. Lord Ganesha, you are Brahmamayaha. Coming to the Anandam that is explained here, this Anandam in our world is of what types? We have three types of Anandam. We go to Panchadashti. Anandam has been described in three ways. The first one that is known to all of us, everybody is aware, is Vishayananda. Vishayeshu Upalabdeshu Tad Ichchaha Paramesati Antarmukha Manovruttehi Anandaha Pratibimbati. This is precisely what I was talking some time back. It is not the jalebi that is giving the happiness. Vishayeshu Upalabdeshu. Whenever what we want is obtained or is jiska bhog hum lete hain, whenever you had the bhog of a vishaya that you wanted, tat ichchaha paramesati. That time, that particular desire gets extinguished for a small time. Then what happens? Antarmukha manovruttehi. The vritti of the mana becomes antarmukha. That means it doesn't go out. That means the chitta is no more kshubda but shanta. That is the time anandaha pratibimbati. That is the time kutastha's reflection is felt by chidabhasa and we feel feel happy. That is called vishaya ananda. What is the problem with vishaya ananda? It requires a vishaya. That is the first problem. Second problem, if the vishaya is there, then the anandam that I get lasts for a very small time. Then what is the solution? Every time change the subject and get. That means every time, like a honeybee, go all over the world and bring a drop of honey. Again, go all over the world, bring a drop of honey. That is what precisely we have been doing. Pehle laga, ek scooter mein mil jayega ananda. Mila, vishay khatam ho gaya. Ab car ki zarurat aa gayi. Now we need a four-wheeler. Four-wheeler aa gaya, lekin wo Ferrari nahi thi. Again, vishay badlo. So every time you keep on changing, so then your rajoguna becomes so active that you start chasing subjects. Kyun? Isme nahi to isme. Sham ka time hai, thoda club chale. Change of subject. Club mein gaye to thoda brand badle. Change of subject. Ye kapda achha hai ki wo saadi achhi hai? Vishay badal. Because vishaya ananda depends on vishaya. So continuously the vishaya has to be changed, because otherwise that one vishaya giving continuous happiness doesn't happen. So this is vishaya ananda. Second anandam is vasana ananda. This I am referring to panchadashi. This is beautifully given there. Vidyaranya Swami has given vasana ananda. What is vasana ananda? Ek ho gaya vishaya ke saath ananda. But sometimes we are happy when there is no subject. Sometimes you feel, I'm feeling better. I'm feeling very good. Why? I can't tell you, but I'm feeling, this does happen. Not very often, but it does happen. After a good sleep in the morning, you just see out and the sun has just come up and the birds are chirping and feel happy. Now there is no vishaya there. So that means that is also called vasana ananda. Yatra yatra vishaye vina sukham syat, tatra sarvatra etam brahmanandasya vasana vidhihi. At that nirvishesha sukha. Nirvishesha sukha. That means ek ananda hai vishay ki vajah se. One anandam is because of vishay. Second anandam is because of absence of vishay. The problem in vasanananda is also, it doesn't last longer. The problem is, you cannot catch hold of anandam for a long time. So when you want to catch hold of the anandam for a long time, if you are going after vishaya, you will never get it. If you are not going after vishaya and trying to hold to the anandam, then the sadhana might take you to a stage of something like samadhi, where the anandam is there. Like Swami Vivekananda went to Ramakrishna Paramahansa, said that, Gurudev, please give me samadhi again, and I don't want to come back for a couple of days. Why? Because that anandam was so superior, because it was Brahmananda, but it was not lasting longer. So that is why, after continuous sadhana, abhyasam, and doing vairagyam, because first you have to discard all the subjects. Then only you can go beyond the subjects. So subjects, no subject, and subject, no subject also is transcended. Then what happens? Then you reach a stage where anandam becomes your vritti. You are anandamaya. And that is when Brahmananda comes to you. Akhanda ekarasanande maya karya varjite. Only when the maya is transcended, maya karya varjite, avasheshatva, sasheshatva, Varta avasara kah asti, Panchadashi says. This is balance, that is balance, nirvishesh, asavishesh, kuch nahi. Everything is obliterated. Why? Because maya is transcended. When maya is not there, vishay kahan se aayega? Vishay ka hona, vishay ka na hona. Both are gone. So, vishay presence and giving sukh, vishay ananda. Vishay absent and giving sukh, vasanananda. Vishay not present, not absent, and yet there is continuous state of happiness, now not going to be obliterated, or there is no badha anymore. That is called Brahmanandam. And that Brahmanandam, tvam anandamaya. This is where the Ganesha is. So if one has to reach the Ganesha, we have to reach here. Tvam Brahmamaya. We already saw Sopadika Brahma. The entire regulator of this, Sopadika Brahma. Sopadika Brahma means all deities, all lokas, everything put together is coming under one, that Brahman which has manifested. So in manifested world, the manifested Brahma, which is Apara Brahma, is you, so you are Brahmamaya. Tvam Sat Chit Ananda Advitiyosi. Now the boundaries have gone beyond. Ek tha, to understand and recognize God in all the things that are around us, trying to see godliness in everything. Dusri stage thi, Apara Brahma dekhne ki. To see Apara Brahman is the second stage. And then transcending the Apara Brahman and Parabrahman, going to the Brahma, is the last stage. That is why a Sufi says, Had had tape wo auliya, behad tape wo peer, had behad dono tape wako naam fakir. That is why Kabir Maharaj says, Man lago yar fakiri me. हाथ में तुम्बा बगल में सोता चारों दिशा जागीरी में. चारों दिशा की जागीर कब मिलेगी? When I have transcended everything. And that is why that which is Brahma, since it has no attributes of any kind, it cannot be described. But the problem is, once we start describing something which is not describable, the page will be empty and the words will stop. If somebody asks you, how is Brahma? No answer. Because anything that you say will become obliteration on Brahma. Because anything, that is the reason Kenopanishada says that moment you say, I know Brahman, you don't know it. And when you say, I don't know whether I know it or not, you will have it. Some third or fourth last mantra speaks about this in Kenopanishada. What it means is, because I cannot understand attribute-less Nitya Shuddha Brahma Shukram, Saparyagat Shukram, Asnavaram, all those, Ishavasya Upanishad describes the tatvam. This, since it cannot be described for our understanding, it is described by taking recourse to the best things that are known to us, which are Sat Chit and Ananda. Sat Chit and Ananda, Advitiya, because there are no two Brahmas. One should not have a wrong perception in the mind that what if the Brahmas are there, but Brahmas are more than one? No. He is Eka, Ekam Eva, Advitiyosi. Why repetition? Ekam Eva bol sakte the? Because it presupposes a possibility that ye Ekam Eva hai, dusra wala ek alag type ka ek aur hai, do do Brahma ho jayenge. It is not so. Ekam Eva, Advitiyosi. Sufi says, jo कहीं दू की बू भी होती तो दो चार होता. ये ना थी हमारी किस्मत के विसाले यार होता. इट इज नॉट इन आवर लक टू सी द ब्रह्मन, बट वन थिंग इज श्योर दैट इट ही इज ओनली वन. क्योंकि अगर दो होता तो फिर चार भी होता. सो देर आर नो मोर ब्रह्मन. सच्चित आनंद स्वरूप ही हैज. सच्चित एंड आनंद स्वरूप तुम प्रत्यक्षम ब्रह्मासी. Now it is here the word Brahma is Brahmasi, not Brahmamaya. In the second pad of this particular mantra, it says Tvam Anandamaya, Tvam Brahmamaya. Here, after that it says Tvam Sachidananda and Tvam Pratyaksham Brahmasi. That means the first one is referring to Apara Brahman. The second one is to Parabrahma. Tvam Pratyaksham Brahmasi. And this is the nature of Ganapati. Lord Ganesha is nothing else but Brahman. And Pratyaksham Brahmasi matlab, Pratyaksh is directly evident. Now the question here is, we need to understand why, what is Pratyaksha? It is a part of the Pramana Paddhati of the Shastra, but Pratyaksham is one of the Pramana. What is Pratyaksham? Pratyaksham is, in the Shastra of Pramana, whatever is there in front of you, you don't have to infer it. You don't have to say that there is a fire at the top of the hill, so there is a smoke at the top of the hill, so there is a fire. No anumana. Not because somebody told you. No, no paroksha jnana. When I have my hand in front of me, I don't require anybody's help to know that this fist is in front of me. This is pratyaksha jnanam. Exactly like that, kartali avale taisa hari tukaramara says, exactly like a gooseberry or amlak fruit in the hand, Brahman can be seen pratyaksham. Why can it be seen? It is not to be seen. That is why tvam pratyaksham pashyati brahmasi no. Tvam pratyaksham brahmasi means it is something that you become Brahma with. The one who knows Brahman, Brahmeva bhavati. If you know Brahman itself, means you become Brahman. You become swasavvedya. So tvam pratyaksham brahmasi, that Brahman which transcend the kshetra and kshetradnya, unmanifest and manifested, sambhuta and asambhuta, that which manifested sopadhika brahma, that which transcends nirupadhik brahma, all that after transcending the one which is the only one, satchit ananda advitiya, that brahman is yutam pratyaksham brahmasi. Tvam jnanamayo vijnanamayosi. Ganesha, you are jnanamaya and vijnanamaya. Jnana and vijnana. We have a jnana vijnana yoga, adhyaya, 7th adhyaya in Gita. It is also called adhyatma yoga. In that, Bhagavan himself says, jnanam te aham savijnanam idam vakshami asheshataha. Jnanam te aham savijnanam idam vakshami asheshataha. What is this? This mantra itself explains what is jnana and what is vijnana. Jnanam te aham. That means Brahma is knowledge. Savidnanam idam vakshami. Savidnanam means with experience you achieve me. Asheshataha, without any iota of doubt or remnant whatsoever. Yad jnatva na iha bhuyo anna jnatavyam avashishyate. Arjuna, if you understand me as part of experience, anubhuti, it is not something which is by vritti jnanam. It is not to be grappled by mind. When you transcend the mind, after that you transcend the time and space, dikkala. When you do the dikkala avacheda, when you transcend that, after transcending, you will experience by yourself, aham, me, mera tum anubhav karoge. But main kaun hu? Jnanam te aham. Bhagavan khud bolte main jnana swarup hu. Matlab Brahma jnana swarup hai. So jnanamayo, that means you are jnanamaya. You are the one who is embodiment of knowledge. And you are the one who are embodiment of experience. So jnanamayo, vijnanamayo si. This is the fourth mantra that we have. After the fourth mantra, the fifth mantra starts telling the glories of Ganapati as Apara Brahman. The Upanishad is moving constantly between Apara Brahma to Para Brahma. Then Apara Brahma, how it is working in the created or the manifested world. What is its relation in manifested world vis-a-vis Maya and the Jeeva and the Ishvara. And then at the same time, it is shuttling between Para Brahman and the Brahman. So in both the cases, we need to understand Ganapati is available in both the forms. That is why Sarva Jagat Idam Tvatto Jayate. Sarva Jagat Idam Tvattah Jayate. Ye jo jitna bhi jag hai, jag is what is jag, world, what is Vishwa jag, ja means to be born or to be created. Sarva jagad idam. Idam. Idam word aagaya, so that is means created. Idam na mama, idam na mama, that means created. Jagat idam tat tvattah jayate. It has been born from you. Ab ye brahma hai, nishkri hai, nirvikar hai, aur vahan se kaise paida hoga phir koi? If Ganapati is Brahma, Parabrahma, Parabrahma is attributeless, it has no functioning whatsoever, there is no change in him, he is avikari, then ye to vishwa to vikar hua na, so how is it that tvatto jayate, how everything is born from you, And that is why everything that is created is called karyam. In Shastra, anything that is created is karyam. Moment you say it is created, it must have a karanam. Karana karya anubandhaya sambandham is something very critical to the philosophy of Hinduism. What is this? This is a body, deha. Deha is created. This is karyam. That means there has to be a karana. I am deha. Why am I a deha? Because of my past deeds, prarabdha vashat, dehavastha. But prarabdha, it is also a karya. By whom? I only did. So if prarabdha is karya, why did prarabdha happen? Because of dukkham and sukham. Okay. But dukkham and sukham, it is also karya. Yes, it is a karya. So dukkham and sukham must have a karana. Yes, it has a karana. What is a dukkham and sukham karana? Anukula pratikula savedana. Okay. So anikool pratikul savedana is a karan or karya? It is also a karya. That means it must be having a karan. Yes, it has a karana. What is the karana? Avidya. What is the karana? Avidya is there. Karana deha. And why the avidya is there? Because of maya tatvam restricted to the jiva. Then what is the karanam that it is existing? Because of Brahman. So the karan adhyasa and karya adhyasa, these are the two things which are always discussed in the shastras. So once we know that every karya has a karana, it also presupposes a theory. And the theory is, whatever is there in the karana will appear in the karya. In other words, no karya in this world is possible unless there is a karanam. And karya is nothing but expression of the cause. Karanam. This is called Satkhyati. This is a technical name for the same thing. That means everything that is created must have a cause. Now, this cause which is there is called a Nirmiti Karan. It can be of two types. Everything that is created has a cause, and the cause can be of two types. One is Upadana Karana, another is Nimitta Karana. We all know that by now. Material cause and instrumental cause. A potter makes a pot. So potter, since he makes the pot, he is the instrumental cause. But only potter if you have, will the pot be made? No. The clay has to be there. So the clay is called Upadana Karana. So clay has been shaped into a pot by the instrumental cause called potter. So we have Upadana and Nimitta Karana. Now the question is, Upadana means the material cause. That means the material comes from that cause to create the karya. So if Vishwa is also a created pot, so iska kumhar kon hai, potter kon hai, aur ye isne kisse banaya hai? To panchamahabhut se bana hai. But wo panchamahabhut bhi karya hai. Phir uska karan kon hai? So as we go back, we realize that the karanam goes to Brahma, Parabrahma. But Parabrahma cannot do anything. And yet he is the karan, upadan karan. How to put this together? Ek aadmi hai bolta main kuch bhi nahi karta hu. At the same time, the second statement is, ye sab api ka kiya karaya. How do we reconcile that? And this reconciliation is done when we understand how a cause works. How the karan works. The karan can cause karya. A cause can cause a work or effect through three ways. One is called parinama. We all know milk becomes curd. So for the curd or the yogurt, what is the cause? Milk. Because milk se hi bana na wo. Nimitta karan jo usme dalte hai, upar se thoda sa dahi, wo nimitta karan ho gaya. But uska material cause jo hai, the apadana karan jo hai, upadan karan is milk only. But this is called parinama. Parinama upadan. Kyu? Now the milk, the curd cannot go back to milk. So it's a permanent change. When the permanent sthiti avasthantar is there, no reversal. Permanent avasthantar, milk to curd, it is called parinama. So is the Vishwa created world a parinama? No. Kyunki parinama hota, to Vishwa se vapis kaise jaate? We will not go into the cause again. एंड यहाँ पे तो ब्रह्म पे जाने की बात हो रही है, शिव की तरफ जाना है, तो फिर जीव परमानेंट हो गया तो जीव शिव की तरफ जाएगा ही नहीं, सो इट इज नॉट अ परिणाम. देयर इज अनदर उपादान कारण, वन टाइप इज देयर कॉल्ड आरंभक, इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड आरंभवाद. वॉट इट मीन्स इज दे से दैट कारणम एंड कार्य दीज आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स ऑल टूगेदर. एंड द एग्जाम्पल गिवन इज वी ऑल नो कॉटन फाइबर्स, उसको तो तंतु बोलते हैं. वेन यू पुट इट टूगेदर एंड वीव, कपड़ा तैयार हो जाता है. तो तंतु में और कपड़े में कोई साम्य ही नहीं है, तो तंतु अलग है, कपड़ा अलग है. सो तंतु इज नॉट द कारणम, इट इज कॉल्ड समावायी कारण. वी आर नॉट गेटिंग इन टू द डिटेल्स, दैट इज एक्चुअली नैयायिकास थ्योरी. द नैयायिक पीपल बिलीव इन दिस आरंभवाद. अकॉर्डिंग टू देम एवरी कार्य इज अ न्यू थिंग. इट मे बी कमिंग फ्रॉम सम सोर्स, बट दैट सोर्स में वो कार्य उपस्थित होता है, जस्ट एक्सप्रेस नहीं होता. इट गेट्स एक्सप्रेस एट एन अपॉर्चुनेट टाइम, दैट इज कॉल्ड आरंभवाद. सो इज द वर्ल्ड समथिंग लाइक दिस? इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. एंड दैट इज वाई the commonest upadana karana theory that is applied for the created world is vivartavad. What is vivartavad? When there is a change of status which is not real but appears real. Ye kya chakkar hai? The commonest example given and beautiful example is there is a rope lying in the darkness, semi darkness, and somebody says, oh, there is a snake there. Now the question is, snake hai, he has not moved, he started trembling, in fact he started sweating also, so that means he saw snake, isn't it? So the snake is existing or not? Because till the time he touches the rope, he will call it a snake. But moment he touches and finds out that it is a rope, that time he will come to know that there is no snake. That means the existence which was seen was unreal, but there was a change of status. So that means till the time it is not sublated, the feeling remains. This is called vivart. Vivart means it is not there but looks like it is there. Pratiti matra sattavan. What is the meaning of pratiti matra sattavan? Till the time you feel it is there, but if you actually go and analyze and somehow see that there is a rope, then the snake vanishes. And this is the way upadana karan on the Brahma of the world is existing. So the world appears to be created by the Brahman, but people like you and me will say that what appears to be created? I can actually touch it. I'm right now talking to 20 or 10 or 40 different people. How can you say this is not existing? In fact, they're listening, I'm talking. But from Brahma's standpoint, it has not happened. Why? Because our interpretation of whatever is happening is the interpretation of a vivarta. Hum log saap ko describe kar rahe hain. So whatever actions we are talking, mujhe dukh hua, mujhe sukh hua, main kya karu, kaise paida hua, so difficult to leave here. All these talks, a jivan mukt laughs at it. He says, kya ho kya raha hai? Sant Ramdas says, aga je ghadle chinahi, kyachi varta pusashi kahi? How can you ask me about something which has never happened? जग की बात कर रहे हो, हुआ ही नहीं है. गौड़ पादाचार्य बोलते अजातवाद, ये हुआ ही नहीं है. एंड वी फील क्या लोग है, रोज तो हम लोग इधर खस्ता खा रहे हैं और ये बोलते हुआ ही नहीं. रीजन वाई दिस इज सो इज बिकॉज दिस विवर्त जो आज सच लगता है, वॉट आई एम कॉलिंग एज ए ट्रुथ, इज गोइंग टू बी सबलेटेड when I will have आत्मदर्शनम. So, in the Atma Darshan Avastha, the world is not going to exist anymore. If this is the case, that means Vishwa is, creation is Vivartata. So, that is why Sarva Jagadidam Tvatto Jayate. Now, we understand that how in Ganapati, the world is created. He is the one who has given the birth to the world. He is Brahman also, and he has given birth to the world also. So, that is how he is taintless as a Brahman, yet he is the originator because the vivarta cannot stand. The vivarta is maya, cannot be alive, cannot be working unless Brahman provides the chetana to it. So it is the borrowed chetana of Brahman on which maya survives and creates the world. The day we sublet the Maya no more remains, only the Brahman remains. So there is no question of sublation. Once sublation is done, no question of creation. So that is why till the time it is existing, sarvajagdidam tvatto jayate. Sarvajagdidam tvaitishthati. After you have created everything, you are the one who are going to maintain it. So tvatto jayate, take your time, you are the Brahma. Tvatishthati Vishnu. Tvai layati. Tvailayam eshyati. It merges in you. It starts from you. It gets birth from you. You are the one who maintain it, because whatever I am doing right now in this so-called created world is because of what? This is the same Chetana that is doing. So when there was nothing, he was there. When something came in existence, it is because of him. That which came in existence worked for some time because of him. And after that work was over, when he felt, he withdrew it back. That also he did as a Shiva. So Brahma Tattva, Vishnu Tattva, Shiva Tattva, through these three things you operate the universe. Hey Lord Ganesha, you are all the three rolled together. Sarva Jagadidam Tvai Pratyeti. Tvai Pratyeti, because of you only, I am able to comprehend Pratiti. I am able to understand what is happening around me. It is only because of when we, and in how many stages we understand. I have a Vyavaharika Satta, I have a Pratibhasik Satta, and I have a Paramarthik Satta. In all this Satta Traya, what is Vyavaharika Satta? Vyavaharika Satta is our Satta, transactional world. Lena Dena, stocks, money, children, family, world, nation, community, surname, height, weight, naam, root, that is all Vyavaharika Satta. We get the pratiti of it. Every day we feel this Satta around us, and that is how we are transacting with each other. But this transactional status or Vyavaharika Satta is alive till when? Till Brahmajnanam. Moment Brahmajnanam comes, Vyavaharika Satta goes away. That is why a Satta that is sublated by Brahmajnana is called Vyavaharika Satta. Then there is one more Satta called Pratibhasika Satta. What is Pratibhasika Satta? Pratibhasika Satta is one that is even sublated by common knowledge, not Brahmajnana. Even common knowledge. Example, the dream state. In the dream, I was a king. So there is a pratiti. For that particular dream, I get the anubhav that I am the king. Moment I am awake, the kingship is gone. So that means I come to know that that satta was not the right satta. It is sublated. So sapno mein, whatever came in dreams got sublated when I am awake. So there is something called pratibhasika satta. Of course, the details are there. The pratibhasika satta is because of tula avidya. The Vyavaharika Satta is because of Trigunatmaka Vidya. And then there is third Satta called Paramarthika Satta. Paramarthika Satta means that which is not Badha in any of the time. Trikala Badhita Satta, that is Brahma. In fact, it is beyond Trikala. So Trikala is a subset of its Satta. So we have Vyavaharika Satta, Paramarthik, that is Pratibhasik Satta, and Paramarthik Satta. So there are Satta Traya. In all these Sattas, there is a Pratiti that you get. In each of these powers, or each of these Sattas, we do get the experience. Till the time the experience itself is sublated into intuition. Even till that time, one who enlivens all that is nothing but Ganesha, Sarva Jagdidam, Tvai Pratyeti. So that means you are the one who takes care of all that is there in terms of Asti Jayate Vardate Vipermanate, which is Vikara Vasha, whatever is there created. You are the creator, you are the maintainer, you are the destroyer. That is why you are Prabhu. Then when you do this creation, this creation again, if you are the one everywhere, hey Ganesha, Sarva Jagdidam Tvai Pratyeti, then why is it that I am not able to see you? The common question is, God is everywhere, but why can't I see him then? If God is everywhere, if I am able to see everything everywhere, why is it that I am not able to see God? Why the Ganesha is not visible to me? And that is where, as Panchadashi gives, Putra Dhvani Shravana Drushtanta. We know our Chetana as a Samanya Tattva, but we don't recognize our Chetana Tattva as a Vishesha Tattva. Samanya Tattva we know. I am able to see, that I know. But I am able to see because of Brahman, that I don't know. Samanya Tattva I know, Visheshatve, I don't understand it. Why? Because an example given is Putra Dhvani Shravana. Supposing that some old Acharya is taking the Veda class and there is a rote going on, the people are doing Pathantara. And suppose a father goes to see how his son is reciting the mantra, let me see. He goes there and he sees that 40 boys are reciting the mantra. Now in that 40 boys' voice, he cannot find out which voice belongs to his son. It is there. So common voice he can hear. That is why common chetana we can see. That is why we know that I am moving, that I know. But specific vishesha chetana, this is my boy who is reciting the mantra, the father cannot come to know. Similarly, we do not know. And knowing him with visheshatva is sadhana. And why we are not knowing the specific thing? Because we have a pratibandha, obstacle. And what is that obstacle? The obstacle is ajnanam atmadarshanasya pratibandha. Panchadashi says ajnana. Ajnana. So, by going by these standards, it will be easier for us to understand the position of Ganesha when it comes to sarva jagdidam tattu jayate, sarva jagdidam tattishtati, sarva jagdidam tvailaya meshyati, sarva jagdidam tvai prateti. If this is the case, then not only the creation of me as a jiva is also his creation, the sthula srushti is also his creation. So for some reason, this whole world is created from where? From prakriti. It is a Sankhya's tatvajna, prakriti. Purusha, by the help of Purusha, prakriti became this universe, or prakriti created, which we call Maya. By vivarta upadana karan. Vivarta upadana karan means not as a causative factor, but as indirect causative factor through vivarta. How indirect causative factor? We saw the Rajju Sarpa Drushtanta. So when this prakriti, she comes to play the dice of creation, she comes with her three fine instruments. Ye pura khel jo hai, prakriti jab khelne ki ichha karti hai, prakriti ichha karti hai, kyunki ichha brahma ko to hoti nahi hai. So kisko ichha hoti hai? When the prakriti or the maya decides to create the universe, she uses three instruments, those are called three gunas, sattva, rajatama. When they are in samyavastha, that means the instruments are in the scabbard, they are not yet used at that point of time, then it is called samyavastha of maya. So it is called moola maya. Moola maya, the maya in its original stage, she has not yet started working. Mahamaya aake to baith gayi hai, but usne apne faase abhi tak daale nahi hai. Tirguna faase liye kar dole, bole madhuri bani maya mahathagini hum jani. Kabir Maharaj says, ye badi mahathagini hai. Ye thagini isliye hai because she creates that maya jal, the illusion. And the illusion is done by help of these three gunas. So that is why Bhagavad Gita is replete with trigunas discussion everywhere. Why? Yahi to teen instrument hai uske jo aapko chhinne hai. If these three are taken away from maya, maya is nischeshta. Nothing she can do. That is why instead of working on what she has created, work on the gunas. That is why the focus is on working on gunas. Creation pe, screen pe kya aa raha hai? Go to the projector. And the projector is three gunas. Panch tattva ka bana putla. भीतर भरा भंगारा, पांच तत्व का पुतला है, पुतले में कुछ नहीं है, वो जो भीतर भंगारा जो है उसमें तीन गुण है, अष्ट कमल दल चरखा चाले, पांच तत्व की पूनी, नौ दस मास बुनन को लागे, तीन गुण धर दीनी, चदरिया झेनी वे झेनी, तीन गुण, दैट इज द त्रिगुण थिंग, एंड दैट इज व्हाई दिस माया तत्व कम्स फॉरवर्ड फॉर क्रिएशन ऑफ व्हाट इज कॉल्ड ए सृष्टि, सृजन, टू पुट फोर्थ, इज सृ इज टू पुट फोर्थ, टू कम आउट, टू डू दैट द माया तत्व यूजेस द त्रिगुणास एज इट्स इम्प्लीमेंट्स, एंड देन वंस शी टेक्स आउट द इम्प्लीमेंट्स व्हाट हैपन्स that is more important, because the last part of this mantra number 5, which says tvam bhumihi apaha anilaha nilaha and navaha, this pancha mahabhutas, now it is talking about all these pancha mahabhutas are nothing else but Ganesha, it is you, how the Ganesha who was taintless nitya shuddha brahma became apara brahma or the kshetrajna. By becoming Kshetradnya, how he took the Kshetra or the Maya into the hand, how he became Purusha so that Prakruti can create the world, and then Prakruti with his three gunas became ready to start that. So once we understand that, then these five words will make sense to us so that we can spot where exactly the Ganapati is. And that is what we will see in the next class. Hari Om. Om Purnamada Purnam Purnat Purnam Udachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Hari Om Hari Om.
Sanjay ji, Hari Om. Sanjay ji, if we chant this Ganapati Atharvashirsha without knowing the complete meaning, will it have any deficiency of chanting that way?
Hari Om. There are two ways the mantra can be said. Whichever way you say it, it will not be a waste. But supposing that you plant a barren soil, it will take time to fertilize. But if you plant fertile soil and give the water, then naturally the crop will come faster. So knowing the meaning, when you stand in front of Ganapati, if you know the backdrop of what Ganesha is, then for dhyanam, because Ganapati Atharvashirsham, a mantra is to be recited keeping the Ganesha as the Ishta Devata in front of you. Now that Ishta Devata with its attribute, both as a Saguna and Nirguna, when it is in your mind, then to focus your mind on that becomes much more easier. Otherwise, it becomes just a recitation. That is why I have seen many, many people reciting Ganapati Atharvashirsham, even with wrong pronunciations and whatever. But the fact is, every word and its meaning, if it is known, then it is like a poetry or a Shakespeare's or a, say, Milton sonnet. If somebody is reading, one can read it. But one who understands, he gets rasam. Rasam vai swaha. That rasam which comes out, the bhavana that comes out, that is cutting short the distance between Jeeva and Shiva. That is why every mantra that we recite, that is the reason mananat trayate. These are mantras. This is mantra means manan. It is not one time or recitation alone. Manana has to be done. So every time the Ganesha comes in front, if the whole back kaleidoscope of the backdrop comes to you, you come to know where you are, who you are in the whole created universe, and vis-a-vis me as a Jeeva, who Lord Ganesha is. And then what happens? Then I start, my I, Ahankar I, starts expanding beyond my body. And then everything in this world I feel is mine. And that is how you start slowly transcending the things. In fact, in sadhana, there can be a specific sadhana like Raja Yoga, which we're anyway going to see Patanjali Yoga Shastra, or there can be a sadhana which increases the sattvikta in you. So Ganapati Atharvashirsha, by mere fact that you are in front of Ganesha, sattva guna upakarsha automatically starts. It goes urdhva. So sattvikta keeps on increasing. Sattvikta increases, the buddhi becomes sharp. penetration of the intellect is powerful. Penetration is powerful, you start understanding Ganesha in a much better way. And that is how the progress is made. And then, Rupa tujhe kaise pahu tyat amilina. You know, one of the saintly person from 12th century says, I had gone to see the God, but I did not know when I became God. That situation comes only when this backdrop of the understanding is there. Hari.
Yeah, well, it is well understood. Whenever we chant some mantra with a real meaning into our mind, you get a different feeling. Whereas if you just simply rehearse it, it is not that effect. So I'm just worried that while chanting, some of the the pronunciation may differ from the actual. So it will not have any side effects, like, you know, even that is what to make.
In Adhyatmam, there is no adverse effect.
Yeah, that's okay. Thank you.
Deepji, you had some question.
Hari Om, Sanjay ji, you talked about the three sattas, pradibhasika, vyavahariga, and paramarthika satta. And you also said that when all the three sattas are sublated, then we reach the Ganesha state. So is it, can you explain? I mean, this paramarthika satta itself is Ganesha state, right?
Or, what happens is, when we say sublation of paramarthik satta, it is in a technical sense. Because when there is, the satta will be only called as a paramarthik satta when other two are existing. It is like saying that sugar is sweet because something has to be bitter. But when you go into paramarthik satta, the satta itself doesn't remain because you are Brahman. So now you cannot be calling, it is like saying, you know, kingdom of that king. The whole kingdom belongs to that king only. So it cannot be called as kingdom. In that sense, paramarthik satta as an understanding, because paramarthik satta itself is Brahma satta. But to understand from the point of view, when we are already calling other two sattas, we say satta traya. So you are transcending all the three sattas is a way of saying. But paramarthik satta is itself a trikalabadit Brahma satta. But when we say trikalabadit, then you are again talking about the upper Brahma satta. That is why we say paramarthik satta is sublated, means you go to Purushottama. And in Purushottama, there is no satta. Why? There is only Purushottama. It is when you go beyond sun, there is no day and night. So similarly, when you go beyond paramarthik satta, and paramarthik satta word itself indicates that satta means somewhere the paramartha has created something and there is a satta under which something is happening. That means you are talking of upper Brahma. In Parabrahman, none of the sattas are existing. None of the gunas are existing. So whatever is happening within the manifested world. And from that angle, the pratiti is from these three sattas. That is why three satta was proposed by Shankaracharya. But paramarthik satta is itself only one satta. Because apart Brahman, aham vibhur vyapya. In Atma Shatakam, Vibhur Vyapya. Vibhur Vyapya means I am the only one occupying everything. So where is the question of Satta? In that sense, it is translated.
Hari Om.
Last week, we are closed 9 o'clock, 9:05, we closed, and then you were raising a question. How many Upanishads were there? You know, one of the Upanishad studies by Dr. TMB Mahadevan, it is saying that there was 1,185 Upanishads were found, and all these Upanishads taught by Sri Ram to Hanumanji. So total, it is saying that 1,185 Upanishads were there. And the Mukhya Upanishads are 107 or 108, including the Allopanishad, which is written by Akbar in the 16th century. And Shankaracharya wrote commentary for 12 Upanishads, including the Dasyopanishad, the Isham, Kenam, Gadam, Prasnam, Mandokyam, Taittiriyam, Aitareyam, Aitareyam, Chandokyam, Brihadaranyam, plus two Upanishads also Acharya is commented upon. One is the Shyadashataram and the 12th Upanishad is the Narasimha Thapaniya Upanishad. So this is, I found in my note. So there was 1,185 Upanishads in total, it is there. Hari Om.
Thank you, Hari Om. Sanjay ji, one question I have is, this also sings praises of Lord Ganesha. So this entire thing is about praises of Lord Ganesha. Now I understand in Vedas, the first part is all about praises of the God. Right? So how this becomes Upanishad and how that is Samhita? So is it just because where it is or the symbolism behind which decides whether it is a Samhita or whether it's a Upanishad?
The difference between the Mantra, Brahman and Samhita and Upanishad is, one is the location, that is the reason why it is called Vedanta, because it is at the ant of Vedas, but that is a common explanation. The uncommon explanation is, moment we talk of Upanishadas, the intellectual or philosophical fermentation of the ideas has culminated into knowledge-giving mantras in the Upanishadas. So we do not find anything as a karma kanda here, it is a jnana kanda. So jnanam is more stressed here, that is why most of the Upanishadas are discussing Mahavakyas in different manner. So that is how suddenly when it says tvam pratyaksham brahmasi, tvam jnanamayo vijnanamayosi, it is talking directly of tatva jnanam. Although in front one deity is taken, for example in many Upanishadas you find stories also. So we have Himaganga Gauri, that is taken as one of the this thing in Keno Upanishad. So you can have different examples, like chariot has been taken as a, or Yama and Nachiketa has been taken as a samvadam. But the entire samvada is towards tatva jnanam. The tatva jnanam that is being focused is hovering always around Jeeva Shiva Milan or Brahma Jeeva Aikya. And that is how, while putting it, it may have some of the praiseworthy things, but the praise again given to that particular deity is in relation with the tatva jnanam. So when we say tvam, and that is why if we look at the commentary given by Guruji on Ganapati Atharvashirsha Upanishad, the Guruji, so in that we find that he has given this particular explanation of tatastha lakshana and swalakshana. Tatastha lakshana means there is a way of saying, for example, near this particular mall, Himanshuji's house is there. This is called tatastha lakshana. I am focusing on the mall and trying to say it is closer to your house. So your house is indicated indirectly. And swa lakshana, this is Himanshuji's house. So in this Ganpati Atharvashirsha, when we say tvameva, 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 these are called tatastha lakshana. Tvameva, but actual lakshana is Brahma. So tatastha lakshana and swa lakshana. So both Swabhava Lakshan and Tathastha Lakshan is simultaneously being discussed. So that is why one way it is a praise. But through praise, the philosophy is slowly being built up and taken to a level. So that is why when it says that Sarvajigdidam Tvatto Jayate, everything is born out of you, it immediately tells us to study how is it that something which is Brahmamaya, how it can create the world. That means you already started moving towards the Tattva Jnana. You went towards the Upadana Karana. You went towards Vivartavada. And that is Tattva Jnana. So the opening mouth, the cap is basically those one or two words. But the moment you open that particular cap, the whole plethora of philosophy comes up. And then more you think about it, mananam. These are all mantras. They presuppose that you will think about it. Because manana trayate, otherwise na trayate. By just by hearting and reading it once, otherwise ek hi bar pad lete. Mananat, because you keep thinking on it. Then when you think, doubts arise in the mind. When the doubts arise in the mind, then there is a way of quenching the thirst of doubts. And those quenching of thirst of doubts happens to the Bhashyam, etc. Then comes the question that you at least get a theoretical background of how the motor car is. इंजन के बारे में पता पड़ गया, स्टीयरिंग के बारे में पता पड़ गया, कितने टाइप होते हैं, कितना हॉर्स पर, सब कुछ पता पड़ गया. दिस इज ऑल व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज परोक्ष ज्ञान. अभी तक गाड़ी चला ही नहीं है. वंस वी डू ऑल दिस, व्हाट इज द रीजन व्हाई वी शुड डू दिस? वी नो क्लियरली वेयर वी आर गोइंग एंड व्हाट इज द व्हीकल आई हैव. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, आई कैन स्टार्ट माई साधना, आई कैन स्टार्ट ड्राइविंग द कार. देन देयर विल बी इश्यूज, इट विल गो लेफ्ट, इट विल गो राइट. A day will come, I will master the vehicle. Similarly, through my sadhana, but my sadhana will not go haywire. Because if the target is medical doctor banna hai, engineering college mein admission liya, that happens in adhyatma to many people. That will not happen in Hinduism. If we do it as called as sampradayika. Sampradayika means by following certain mahajano yena gataha sapantha. So mahajana, gurudev. Whatever Gurudev, Vivekananda, Ramakrishna, Jnanadeva, Tukaram Maharaj, Eknath Maharaj, Ramdas Maharaj, whatever way they went, we are going the same manner. Why? Because they have reached the destination. So that is why it is Upanishad, full of philosophy, tatva jnanam, compelling us to think, manana. That is why they are mantras. Hari Om.
One sarvato mam pahi pahi samandhat. That I want to know what is pahi pahi.
Ahi pahi samanta. If you look at the word in terms of the meaning, the Sanskrit meaning that we are talking about, it means please, request. It is a request. Sarvatomam pahi pahi. Praying again and again. So please protect all around. Please protect me all around. That would be the literal translation of Sarvatomam pahi pahi samanta.
हरिओम
हरिओम.